I miss traveling. That's the only thing that you can't do with kids. It's too hard to travel. I can't do it. I haven't been on vacation in 3 years. I haven't gone anywhere. The last place we went on vacation, we went to Washington, D.C. Me and my wife, we went on vacation. I'd never been. I always wanted to go because I love American history. And when we went to D.C., the first place I wanted to go was the Lincoln Memorial because I think Abraham Lincoln was the greatest man who ever lived, and I wanted to go pay my respects. And if you guys can point me toward a worse memorial for a greater man, I'm all ears, because I don't know what Confederate architect designed that piece of shit. I don't know what the bid was like. Well, what do I know about Lincoln? Well, big ugly giant, so we'll make him like 50 feet tall. Also a race trader, so we'll put him in an electric chair. And just in case the electricity don't fry his giant bones, we'll put him behind prison bars. If you want a real tribute to Abraham Lincoln, you gotta go to Ford's Theater, which is ironic because that's the place where he was shot. But that's really like, if you wanna like learn about the man's life, you have to go to Ford's Theater. And it's a fascinating museum. It's got all these like things. It's got the hat, the bullet they pull out of his brain. I don't, that was weird, but. We went on the tour, and at the end of the tour, we're sitting in the seats in the on the floor, and there was a park ranger on the stage. She's giving this speech about how the president was killed during a performance of the play Our American Cousin. And I raised my hand, and I said, hi, have they ever performed that play here again? She goes, no, that would be in poor taste. And I go, of course, because that's the play the president watched when he was shot. And she goes, no, because it sucks. Just a little footnote on history. You guys might not know that Abraham Lincoln was murdered during a performance of the play Our American Cousin would be the equivalent of the sitting president being assassinated during a direct-to-DVD American Pie sequel. Like, it's... it's technically a comedy, but it is not funny at all. I bought a copy of the play on my way out because, you know, whenever I go, I like to get a souvenir, and they didn't have any t-shirts in my size that said I went to Ford's Theater and didn't get shot in the back of the head. And if there had been a way to throw that play out the window of the plane without depressurizing the cabin and killing us all, I would have, because that thing is a hunk of shit. Here's the funniest line in the play Our American Cousin, and we know this because John Wilkes Booth, the assassin, was so familiar with the play that he timed his gunshot so that it would be drowned out by the laughter that follows this line of dialogue. So what I'm saying is the words I'm about to share with you are so funny, I should be able to shoot any man in this room, including the leader of the free world, a man who everyone must have been staring at, like nudging the blacksmith or apple seller or whatever dumb profession doesn't exist anymore. They're like, hey, chum, is that Abraham Lincoln up in that booth? I'm not quite sure. I've only seen pencil drawings on account of this being olden days, but. So this line of dialogue I'm about to share with you from Our American Cousin, so funny, I should be able to kill anybody in this room. Get away scot-free, okay? Here's the line of dialogue. Don't know the manners of good society, eh? Well, I know enough to turn you inside out, old gal. You sock-dologizing old man-trap. The last three words that the greatest man who ever lived ever heard were sock-dologizing old man-trap, which roughly translates into modern English as sock-dologizing old whore, because we don't have a translation for the word sock-dologizing, because that word is fucking stupid. If you said sock-dologizing in front of my wife, I would punch you to death. That's how offensive that word is to my ears. And that was his plan, and it worked. That's what's so insane about the assassination of Abraham Lincoln. That plan worked. Some idiot just said sock-dologizing old man trap. John Wilkes Booth pops the president in the back of the head. Then he very sneakily, very stealthily jumps to the middle of the stage, breaking his leg on impact. He yells, "Sic semper tyrannis," and then he gets out the back of the theater on a horse that he had stashed inside the building. And nobody stopped him. The guy who just said sock dollar guy's an old man trap just watched this guy land in the middle of the stage and then get out of the back on a giddy up horse. I don't know if you guys have ever very quickly mounted a horse before. I know I never have. But I have to imagine that it's infinitely harder when you've just shattered your fucking leg. He watched a man throw the shards of his leg over a saddle and then leave. What could he have done? He has a single-shot pistol. It's in the museum. You can see it. It's a single-shot pistol, and guess what, gang? He just used it to shoot the president. What could he have done? Like, land on the stage and be like, whoa, hey, everybody be cool, okay? I know you recognize me. I'm John Wilkes Booth. Cool, all right? Everybody just stay calm. Nobody move. Or I will reach into my breast pocket where I keep the satchel of gunpowder. I need to reload this gun. I'll very carefully untie it, very gingerly pour it in the muzzle of the gun, hoping that the adrenaline pouring through my veins from just having assassinated the president does not cause me to accidentally pull the trigger and blow my face off. And then I will shoot one of you. And then I'll start the painstakingly slow process of reloading this gun, and I will shoot another one of you. If you give me a barrel full of gunpowder, a cloth dipped in morphine to deal with the pain of my shattered leg in a chair, I'll shoot all 661 of you. My name is Sean Sullivan. You guys have been a lot of fun. Good night.
One more time for Sean Sullivan, everybody!